Okay, so I'm going to do a circuit of the pet battle trainers on my new priest that I boosted on a different realm so I can raid with a friend, come warlords. For this circuit, I like to start off up here with a thundering Pandaren spirit and then go down and make like a... We'll just go down, loop around, and this way. Kind of like the Japanese no, or like a circle going to the end and then looping around. That's the best way I found to do it. And then I have a whole bunch of teams already set up, and to properly two-man all these guys so I can level up a pet. The first one, I'm going to start leveling up my new rat. Not rat, I forget what it's called. There it is, Widget the Departed. I'm gonna put you right here. Let's see. Dive, acidic goo, ooze, touch, missile, explode, decoy. Okay. Looks like I've got my first team all set up. And time to take on the Pandaren pet chow. I really wish Safari Hat was working right now. The Safari Hat, all you do is click them once and you're in. Okay, so for this, you set up a dive right off the bat. Probably could do a goo now since dive has 100% chance to hit. It used to be you just dive off the bat because it had 80% hit chance, and with a high chance you were going to miss. And if it missed, you just gave up because you don't take any damage through that first one. But it doesn't really seem necessary. Let's see, he always starts off with the stun. Doesn't really matter with my critter. He has Rapture, which has 25% to stun, which doesn't matter because I'm a critter. And he has Stone Shot, which is elemental damage. Yeah. Snails counter elementals super hard. Okay, Sludgy. Sludgy, I just stick with my snail until Sludgy is dead. I mean, until I'm dead. The snail never kills Sludgy. He always dies after like 2 or 3 hits. But I get off 2 hits on my own, plus a 25% debuff. Alright, I should die this round, since he no longer has that chance to... Ooh, Expunge has 100% chance to hit now, too. Damn, that used to be like 80 or something. Okay, Dark Moon Zeppelin. With the Zeppelin, I think I save Decoy, so I just spam Missile. But I only get hit once by this dude. This is like my first time going through the rotation of Pet Tamers after the patch. They changed a lot of stuff around. I'm pretty sure my old team should still be able to do it. One more missile. I am loving the 100% hit chance on missile, though. Boom! Hits every single time! Ha! Even if it does do a little bit of damage sometimes. Sludgy's out. Okay, with the Tunneler. I think he sets up Stone Skin first and then goes into Burrow, so I can get off one missile. I think I land up getting hit once. It doesn't really matter what the hell my health is. And then I set up Decoy because he's going to bury underground because he's faster than me. Then I spam Missile until he's below 600 health. And then I explode. Because one stone rush is enough to kill me from full to dead. But I still come back to life. Ooh. Ooh. Shoot, that's really close. 645. Is that enough? He's gonna stone skin right now, which will make him do a damage himself. That should be enough to explode. Because all I want to do is die on my Zeppelin. While at the same time killing his Tunneler. That way, this dude gets all the experience without ever having to enter the battle. 618. Okay, so it was... Yeah, it had to be under 600. And now he gains all that juicy extra experience. This is a dude on a new realm. I don't have any pet sausages. So he only goes up to a level 11 right there. Doesn't matter. Oh shit, actually I don't have any bandages either. I might get some from this pet supplies though. Bandages are just ways to heal up your pets instantly. Ooh, nice, a battle stone. And 4 bandages. I'll be using those. All right, on to the next tamer. Just due west. I don't even have the stuff explored yet. Plus everything's all messed up because my computer's terrible, so I have view distance down to as low as possible. Let's see, that dude next up on the list. Let's see, I'm just gonna trade him out for that one. And this is my team. Looks like I start off with this guy. Black Claw, Leap, Bite. Okay, I remember the strategy for this guy. What I do is I just switch out the pet I want to level up with the pet that I leveled up last time, because all of these teams are set up for two pet strategies for all the tamers. That way I can just level up pets like crazy while I do the dailies. Plus, it's a nice way to get gold on my new tune. And this is a PvP server, so I hope I don't get attacked because I'm wearing the greens right now. Okay, next up, Aki the Chosen. I've got my team all set up for this. Ooh, I could set up Call Darkness. That would be stupid though. Ooh, worst type advantage right there. I'm fine though. Okay, now onto the Zandalari Ankle Render. In which case, I'll bite until he's almost dead. And then I have to kill him with Leap. Because I need to be able to outspeed his dragon in order for this two-pet strategy to work. He heals up, that's fine, as long as I don't accidentally kill him with Bite. Okay, now I'm going to start Leap spamming. Oh shit, healed up. Still going to Leap spam though. Nice, killed him. Okay, I've got that Leap up, 100% boost, which means I can set up Black Claw. And hopefully I'll die right here. If I don't, that's actually kind of bad. Ooh, I'm dead. That sucks. That means I lose out a turn. That's fine. I should still be okay, though. Good thing Black Claw lasts for 3 turns. The thing is, he's faster than me. So if I don't die that turn, that means it's just one extra turn for his Black Claw to go away. This turn, I set up my Clockwork Gnome and I just put up Torrent. That way he takes extra damage from Black Claws and the weather he so kindly put up for me. This should be enough to kill him unless they changed it. Okay, yeah, it sometimes didn't kill him before too, so it looks like they left the Torrents the same. Wow, they didn't do anything to Torrent. I guess they thought it was fine. Still a little OP. Only Clockwork Gnome can use Torrent. And it lasts for 4 turns and has a 2-round cooldown, so after 2 turns, it's up. Twice. So for this turn, I'll have 2 turns up doing extra damage with Lightning Storm. 25% extra damage since it's mechanical damage, plus an additional 35 bonus damage for every hit. So it's pretty nice. Looks like the Clockwork Gnome might die though. Yeah, that happens sometimes when the Zandalari doesn't die right away. Ugh. Oh no! I should still be able to kill him though. Plus my carry pet is an undead, so I should be fine. Once he's below 50% health, he uses survival anyway, so that should give me enough time to whittle down his health and set up an extra turret. Alright, I'm good. This dude's as good as dead. Just gotta set up my other turret. He'll probably kill me on the next turn, in which case the turrets will take him out. Yeah, because he won't have survival anymore. He still has 1 turn on dive. Yep, looks like I'm good. I don't even have to attack, because I'm just gonna die. Surge too quick, but the turrets kill him. And he gets all the bonus. You know, he didn't really do anything. He's already at level 16 after 2 battles. That's only with the hat. If I had one of my boost though, he'd be at like 20 by now. Let's see, pet supplies. I got some more bandages. That's good. I'm gonna need those later on. Because I use fairy dragons like crazy. Let's put him in this team. You know, I can fly while doing this. The next one's just due south. South, right? I think I said north last time. Yeah, it's this way. Okay, let's look at my team. Dreadful Breath, Acid Rain, Swallow You Whole, Whirlpool, Healing Wave, Snap. I only need Acid Breath and Swallow You Whole. I don't need Dreadful Breath. I also don't need Cursed Doom, so it doesn't really matter. This dude comes out for 1 turn. Can he do anything useful in the turn he's out? Not really. Don't really need him to do anything anyway. I see him come out for one turn to take a hit. Oh, I don't have all the... Oh yeah, that's right. I got bored of trying to catch all the pets in this area. I've got all the good pets. But collecting all pets was something I just kind of got bored of. It's too time consuming. Stupid PvP server. If he attacks me, I'm dead, because I am in greens right now. Okay, first up, to set up Acid Rain, because he's gonna go straight into sunlight. And then spam Swallow Evil, which does an additional 25 damage under Cleansing Rain. Plus an extra 50% damage since he's an elemental type. Whoa! Solar Beam crit. I usually have a lot more health. Okay, now Toothbreaker comes out. Oh, I forgot what this guy does. I think he uses Leech Seed right off the bat. And then he submerges, which means I can get off one more Swallow You Whole. Nope, he submerged immediately. Ooh, that sucks. It's been so long I forgot how to do this. Okay, and then go into my crab. Because a crab can set up an ability while he's underground. Which is why I usually switch out immediately, but whatever. It don't even matter. I just need Whirlpool to go off while Cleansing Rain is still out. Because it does a lot of damage. I don't need to heal up yet, I can save that. Aw, didn't kill him. Oh well, that's fine, I still have... No, he's dead. He's not faster than this guy. Okay, this dude starts off... I should just go into a healing wave to start off with. Get it on cooldown now, because I'm going to need it. I'll probably burrow, which allows me to set up Whirlpool. And then I can just snap him to death. Because I take less damage from consume. And snap. Oh, it has 100% hit chance now. Oh, I love this. Especially since my crab hits like a truck. Okay, I should heal up right now. My crab heals for a third of his health. And then just spam. Snap until he's dead. Yeah, one more snap should kill him. And he joined the battle. Oh wait, that's right, consume actually heals him up. Ooh, how annoying, because he's gonna burrow right now. Set that up, and there's a good chance I might die right here. Ooh, that sucks. Well, this will go off in one turn, so I should be fine. Usually I don't lose a pet on this guy, because he's easy. And Whirlpool! Alright, looks like he's the last surviving member again. One more battle. Oh shit. Two more battles to level him up. Hello. Farewell. I'm not used to this whole... not using a... pet XP boost. Next up, we got this dude. He's kind of a pain in the ass. This is where I start using lots of fairy dragons. Fairy dragons are really good for the Pandaren pet tamers. Okay, we've got decoy, explode, missile. This dude's skill set doesn't matter. Moonfire, life exchange, arcane blast. And it looks like this is the speed version of it. So I have two of these guys. One speed and one power. The Departed. What pet am I going to level up next after that, dude? He should max out halfway through the run and I'll have enough time to level up someone else. I haven't really thought it out. Maybe... Petalfoot? Do I have Petalfoot? Should be in here somewhere. I'll look for him later. Next up, where is this dude? Oh, it's on the other. I don't have. Yeah, I totally have one of these. This dude. Accept and let's go. His first guy, I'm pretty sure he goes straight into an acidic goo, so I can missile him first. Then set up decoy while he goes underground, and then spam missile. I don't think this is a team that I use the explosion strategy with. I just kinda have it because the other option's bad. Dang, two crits, that's really good. Okay, this one I take the sleep first before I switch into the fairy dragon. I mean, it's not a guaranteed sleep, but it does happen more often than not. Then he lowers my speed. Is there really even a reason for me to use the speed version over the power one? If I just get my speed lowered through mothballs. I think I have to outspeed this guy in order to actually use the fairy dragon. That's why I do it. Ooh. Only 10% boost, though. Plus the 50% boost from my racial, and one more should kill him, unless I sleep. Nice, stayed awake. Looks like the speed boost should end this round, which allows me to outspeed this guy and heal up. Life exchange, or life equalizer as it really should be called. That was a huge heal. Let's see, if I bring him below 50% here... Oh wait, I still need to switch this guy in. What I was thinking of doing was using an Arcane Blast in order to bring above 50% to activate my racial. And then hit him with a superpower of Moonfire since it hits a lot harder. Okay. That's good. He's really low health and I'm almost dead, which means I can just put this guy in. If he hadn't died, that would have been a problem. Ooh, I can Devour to heal up. Why not? Devour doesn't really hit that hard. And I heal up. Nice. Doesn't really matter. Okay, it should be like 20. Only 22? Wow, how many pet battles is it going to take with just the hat? Alright, time to fly to the next dude. If I go on this course, I should be able to tab out. Okay, next one. Looks like I used the Raven and the Fairy Dragon, which means I have to use one of my bandages now. Right, or... Oh, still 3 minutes on it. Okay, I'll use one of my bandages to heal him up, because I use the Fairy Dragons a lot. Okay, next team. I should probably click on it. I keep this guy in for 2 rounds, and I bring out my fairy dragon, and then finish off with my crow. Although I have a better crow now, I should probably update that. Zephros the Elite. There. I think that saves if you just move it in there. And this is a kind of a long one. On my other priest, I could have just used my teleport, but I don't have that on this guy, because he doesn't clear it. Anything. He has nothing, this dude does. It's a brand new character. Don't even have professions. I thought they were supposed to like give you professions when you boosted a character. I don't know how to do that though. Or if that's even a thing, I might just be remembering wrong. Alright, we're here.
Tell me of your travels.
Let's rumble! Did I open up my last pack? Nothing useful, nothing useful. Yep, that's how most of these go. I got lucky that first time getting a rare battle trinket, whatever it's called. Widget the Departed. Damn, I'm gonna be doing no damage to this guy. my game decided to lag out. It's no thing. One hit. Second hit, just to take up the two dots. That way I can just go into my guy who takes less damage from just slicing wind. Because nether fairy dragons destroy flying types. Set up Moonfire. Actually, I don't think I need the speed one for this guy either. Because this guy, he's too fast. I can't outspeed him. He's dead. I don't really think I need to, though. I think I actually kill this guy on this one, and then I need to outspeed the turtle, which my other one can't, so I think that's why I use this one. I'm trying to remember why I'm doing this strategy. Then he burrows this turn, so I just use his turn that I can't hit him to increase my stacks of Arcane Blast. Oh, fuck, it crit. Ooh, this really fucks me over. Ooh, that's bad. Really bad. That was not supposed to happen. Okay, I can Alpha Strike a few times and then Nocturnal Strike. But I think my best bet is just to Nocturnal Strike since he's really high in health right now. I should still be able to take out the turtle though. I just won't have Nocturnal Strike, which kind of sucks. Still have Alpha Strike, but now it has a 90% hit chance since I've gimped myself with Call Darkness. Okay, no crit. No stun. Which means I'm not super unlucky today. And looks like I might be able to finish him off. I got a nice lucky crit out of Alpha Strike. Nocturnal Strike? Oh, I worried over nothing. This lucky crit didn't even mean anything. Still took him out with two pets. Level 23. Oh shit. He would have been level 25 already if I had used the other one. Oh shit. 5 daily quests. Aw yeah. Alright, time to go to the Wind Tamer. This guy's actually kind of hard. Okay. Next up on this list. Oh shit. Oh, I hate it when this happens. Looks like when I was on Team 6, I stopped and then I redid my team. Ugh. I'm gonna have to recreate this team from memory. Okay, let's see. This dude uses a lot of wind type pets, I think. Because he's the wind spirit. He starts off with a flying type and then goes into 2 fairy dragons. I think that's what I need to do. Just 2 fairy dragons. That should be enough to take him out. Yeah, let's go with that. And a spectral strike. Ooh, spirit claws. Hell yeah. And prowl. Ooh, spirit crawls. Always hits when it weathers moonlight. Both my fairy dragons. Ooh, the synergy. It's too much. Too much synergy. Let's go, Grandmaster Pet Tamer. He starts off with Dusty. I'm just gonna take the mothball to the face, see if I can get off a spectral strike. Yep. Sleep. Let's see. This dude, I don't know what his speed is. 315. I should be able to outspeed him. I'm just gonna go into the power guy. It's a little bit harder. Save the speedy guy for last. Because he can outspeed this guy. Okay, he's in a cocoon. I really don't want to waste. I do want to set up Moonfire. But also hits really hard, so I don't want to waste it on a cocoon. Now, Moonfire! Mothballs, 50% hit chance. That buffed Nimbus. Okay, now I just spam Arcane Blast. No sleep. That's good. This Arcane Blast. Oh, crap. That's fine. Even if it's blocked by the cocoon. Oh no, I don't get the bonus for that next round though. Oh well, my Arcane Blast is gonna build up a lot of stacks. Oh, it still killed him. I was not expecting that. Okay. Life Exchange to start off with. It's always best to start off with it when you're at the least amount of health and when your opponent's at the most amount of health. Let's see, if I Arcane Blast a few times, I might be able to get off a nice powered Moonfire. Was that enough to activate my racial? Yep, nice, a buffed Moonfire. Come on, be enough to kill him? Ooh, not quite. That's fine, I've got some mega stacks of my Arcane Blast right now. Ooh, but I'm not faster than this guy. He starts off with a heal anyway, it doesn't matter. Got my mega buffed Arcane Blast and my Dragon Racial. Well, I should be fine. Damn, 650 damage. I'm just gonna keep spamming Arcane Blast because I'm probably gonna die my next turn. Got my Racial. Let's see if I can get this off. I'm not hopeful. Yeah. Plus, I'm kind of helping him out here. Okay, my second Fairy Dragon. I should start packing up my Arcane Blast. Because I really want to save Moonfire for when he's low. Ugh, that heal though. Gives that 25% boost. Ooh, it was enough. Okay, that's good. Moonfire him down a little bit. And Arcane Blast him to death. Can't go wrong with two Fairy Dragons. Because I still got this dude right here who got that Spirit Claws. Ah, he's dead. Second Spirit Dragon was more than enough. Probably could have used Cro-Magnus too. He probably would have done fine. Ready for turn in. Complete quest. I was expecting to run into a lot more people than I have. That's nice. Really don't want to run into Alliance scum. That's too funny. I got a comment on one of my videos. It's like, you calling all Alliance players 12-year-olds really shows how immature you are. No, it was way more than that. He was really mad that I called Alliance players 12-year-olds, and I found it hilarious. Oh shit, I forgot to switch teams. No, I fucked up my 5 team. Okay, that's fine. He's at level 25 now. I need to find a new pet to level up anyway. I'll deal with that mess later. No, wait, I think I remember. Fairy Dragon, Fairy... Actually, I can probably use Cro-Magnus. Or Crominus. And then this one was Zephros. Zephros the Elite. Named after a Yu-Gi-Oh card. So I'm a Yu-Gi-Oh nerd. There's still some time till I get to this next one. Okay, what am I gonna level up next? Petal Feet. I really want to level up this guy, but I don't have a humanoid thing right now. What about the Dandelion Frockler? He has Dazzling Dance, which is pretty nice. Plus he's fast as shit, which makes his kick actually useful. I don't know. Maybe. He's on the back burners. Flayer Youngling. I need the SS breed, otherwise he's useless. Do I have any cool mechanical pets that I've been meaning to level? Ooh, the Iron Starlet. That's right, I forgot about this guy. Actually, I don't even know if I... Yeah, he's mechanical. Mechanical pets have that added bonus of being really easy to level. Because even if they get one shot, they still come back to life. Unless it's a multi-turn hitter. Which this guy might be, I don't know. Don't really matter. Okay, Courageous Yawn. Let's fight.
We serve so others do not have to.
Okay, looks like he's not a multi-turn hitter. Oh shit, barely survived. That's crazy. I don't think he has any moves that actually hit my entire team, so he should be fine in the back row. Okay, he's going first, which means I can just Moonfire and be safe. Moonfire to boost up my Arcane Blast by 10%. And then just Arcane Blast until he's dead. To use his damage reducer on my other guy. See, this guy's 311. Ooh, I outspeed him. Okay, that's why I use the SS1 on this guy. That's a slow-ass rabbit. For an epic quality. Ooh, I didn't really take that much damage, though. Still gonna life exchange, though. It's the best move right here. It heals me up and does respectable damage to him. Now he's gonna burrow, which means I'm just gonna build up arcane blast stacks while he's underground. Boom! Arcane blast. Arcane blast does more damage than Moonfire. Oh crap, I'm dead. Oh, that's inconvenient. Bombing run. Darkmoon Zeppelin has bombing run? Since when? I thought he had flyby. I must be thinking about the other guy. Whatever. Crap. In order to two pet things, you have to have one of your pets be able to do some major work. Okay, I should be fine. I don't know. The goat hits really fucking hard. I need bombing run right here, and I need my decoy in order to block his chew, which he set up. Okay, this is where I decoy. He's gonna hit me with a stampede like he usually does, which means I'll take double damage, and then I decoy in order to block his chew. Even though decoy gets destroyed by a stampede, it doesn't matter. I just don't want to take a double damage chew. Decoy's gone, of course it is, because stampede's multi-hit. And I should be fine by just spamming missile. Plus my bombing run should explode on the next turn. Come on, bum. He's dead. Ooh, looks like I worried for nothing. Still remembered my pet strategy. Looks like the Iron Starlet's at level 11 now. Which means he should be fine for the next guy. Because the next guy has a move that hits my entire team. I think it's the fire pet tamer. It's pretty close too. Okay, the next guy. Spook my Iron Starlet right here. Switch to this team. Oh, Crush has 100% hit chance now. That's so awesome. Okay. This should make this next fight go a lot quicker. Usually this fight takes forever just because I'm Crush spamming and it used to miss all the time because I only had a 80% chance to hit. Plus I use Sandstorm on this one, so it goes down to, I'll go down to 90, I still might miss. I only have a 90% hit chance, but I should still be fine. Iron Starlet, when do I switch this guy in again? I don't remember. Ooh, Demolish. That'd be pretty nice, because they buff Nimbus, the move that increases your team's chance to hit by 20% for 9 turns. Used to only be 10%, and it was kind of useless. At 20% though, that's a noticeable bump. Hello, Pandarian pet tamer. Let's rumble. I think I'm half done now. This guy, he sets up Cyclone, which means I can get off a Crush first before setting up my Sandstorm. Boom! Look at all that damage, and it hit! I'm so loving this 100% hit chance thing. And then I just deflect his Liftoff, Deflect always goes first. That's why Anubish idols are great. Sandstorm to reduce the damage of his Cyclone on my team. And it also reduces the dot damage I'll take from the next guy. Crush spam. I do way more damage to him than he does to me. So I heal up a little bit after every turn. And I actually just like straight up don't take damage from this next guy for a while. He starts off with Conflagrate. I don't remember his move pattern. I'm just gonna spam Crush. Yeah, he starts off with Conflagrate for some reason instead of immolating first. And then he heals up on this turn. I think. I'm gonna refresh Sandstorm right here because I'm pretty sure he heals up, which made my Crush useless. Whatever, and then I'd use this turn to switch into my carry pet, who's gonna get hit by his immolate. Ooh, that's a lot of damage. I might actually die in the back row. Shit. Oh, I didn't think about that. Oh, crap. He might actually die. Okay, and now I just spam Crush, because he doesn't recast it, and then I just deflect his Conflagrate. Okay, looks like, no, he's doing fine. Sandstorm is protecting him. He heals up. Oh shit, he healed up a lot. Need to refresh Sandstorm, that way I don't take any damage. I mean, I'll still take damage from his dot, but very little. Since Sandstorm prevents 74 of it. I should be able to crush him to death, since he doesn't hit me for like another two turns. Ooh, missed. That's fine. Sandstorm reduces my chance to hit by 10%, so that happens sometimes. Survived his Conflagrate. That's surprising, actually. Okay, now this one, I just need Sandstorm to go away. That way I can put out Cro-Magnus and just one-shot him. Maybe do a little bit of damage to him before I die. Okay, and I can go into Cro-Magnus and just blow him up. Howl and Surge of Power, and he's dead. He's not gonna be able to kill me. Now he's taking double damage, and the hardest hitting magic type ability in the game against a pet that takes extra damage from magic type, plus he's taking double damage. Yeah, it did about 150% of his health. I do need to do a little bit of damage to him. That was more than enough. That was super overkill. Okay, next guy. Next dude. He's pretty easy. I think the fire one's probably the hardest. Or it used to be, just because Anubish Idol's so vital to that, and he used to have a really high chance to hit. I mean, really low chance to hit. Okay, what am I doing? Putting this guy on my next team that uses Dive, Acidic Goo, Ooze Touch. This dude's moveset doesn't matter. This one does, and it looks like he's fine. The Jade Owl is really good at taking out Aqua types because he has Flying type moves and he takes less damage from Aquatic abilities. Aqua types, right? Zephyros is also really good at taking out a call. Whatever. I'm pretty sure I have this guy in here for a reason. I think I have him in here because he has that ability to actually dodge a move. With this guy, I have to switch in my carry pet because he starts off with a dude who casts an ability which doesn't allow you to switch out. But Snells absolutely wreck elemental types with elemental attacks. Thanks to Dive and its 200% hit chance. Same with Acidic Goose, he takes 24% more damage. Damn, 1,000 damage. And just Ooze Touch to finish him off. Okay, now the next guy's just a Snell who doesn't hit very hard. Yeah, I can just switch in. I don't really need to worry about anything. I'm pretty sure he's gonna go straight into the acidic goo before using his dive. It's just a copycat. And if I use this turn to switch, I'll be taking extra damage. Whatever, I should be fine. No need to worry. Oh, actually, I should have went to my owl. That's why I have the owl, because he has thrash and it. Oh, crap. Crap. It's an aquatic ability. I should be fine right here. Then I just need to adrenaline rush so I outspeed him. That way, thrash does maximum damage. There we go. That's why I use the owl. I was wondering why the hell I was using the owl over my crow. Because crows are way better for aqua types. Yeah, because he's also really good at taking out critters because of his thrash. Damn. I should be able to kill him with adrenaline rush. Ugh, that sucks. You don't want that to happen with adrenaline rush. Going fast on the turn that they submerge. Oh no. Oh no. Oh, this is not good. Oh, I pretty much. I don't think I can beat this next guy with my snail. Really needed my guy. Ugh. Ugh. Oh, I'm in a bad place right now. Okay, I've got the goo set up, and I need to be underground when he sets up his sooth. So I'm going to ooze this turn, and then dive. That way I dodge that. Oh, I'm a snail. I don't need to worry about that. I forgot. I almost forgot I'm immune to all CC. Okay, just spamming ooze touch. Oh, crap. Crap, this guy's moveset is terrible. Powerball, supercharge. Ooh, looks like I'm just gonna have to do this and hope it's enough to kill him. Come on, multi-turn move, be enough to kill him. Ugh, he healed up. Yes. Whew. Good thing he hits as hard as a really weak level 25 pet, since he's a power type. Ooh, I got dicey. Still recharging. I thought 4 minutes remain on its cooldown. I don't think I need any of these pets for the next guy. I know I need the owl for the tamer after. Okay, I'm on the second to last tamer. Second to last tamer. Ooh, this next guy's the hardest guy, I think. I should actually set up this guy's moveset. Looks like I start off with Zephyros, and then I go into Elemental Killer. Damn, I don't remember the strategy at all for this next guy. Toxic Smoke. Supercharge is gonna have to work. Increase the damage of your next attack made within one round by 120%, which makes it worth to use off cooldown, but also makes it really easy to dodge. But computers usually don't dodge your attacks, so I should be fine. Okay, I just got these two guys left. And those are the last two on this thing, and how long has this been going for? Really long time, I think. Okay, we're closing on the next guy. This next guy is actually a bit of a pain, and probably the hardest guy to two pet. Ooh, it always goes into lag as soon as I start it back up. Yeah, this dude's definitely the hardest guy to two pet.
Hello.
I think, I can't remember.
Next one is on me.
He's a pain in the ass, what? That's for sure.
Made a miss.
I really wish I remembered, because I'm pretty sure he requires a very specific strategy. Okay, he's got Crusher. He starts off with his Renewing Mist, I think. So should I go straight off to a Nocturnal Strike? I think so. That way it reduces his chance to heal. Oh, fuck, that's the wrong button. I meant to call Darkness. Okay, that's fine. I don't think there's a penalty for quitting out on these guys, is there?
Greetings,
nope.
Jade Circle.
Ooh, that was bad. Okay. Call of Darkness. You really can't make mistakes like that, especially at the beginning. Especially since this guy's the hardest one to two pet. Just because this dude right here is a pain in the ass. Ha, your search missed. And my pet hit. Okay, for this one, if I switch into my Elemental Killer now, he's gonna die. Because Whirlpool hits him like a truck. Oh shit, it missed. That's not what I wanted. These attacks. Ugh, and I take extra damage from Sandstorm, and I can't switch out now. For two rounds. Yeah, Zevros is gonna die. Also, Nocturnal Strike doesn't work on him. Because it always hits if they're blinded, but he's not affected by weather effects, so. Oh, I should say Cold Darkness doesn't work on him. And Zephyros is dead, and now it's time to go into my Elemental Killer. For this strategy, do I use Curse of Doom? Or do I Acidic Rain and just swallow you whole spam? I'm just gonna Acidic Rain and then swallow you whole spam. Because that 25 extra damage under Cleansing Rain is nothing to laugh at. Especially since it's gonna hit really hard right now. As long as I don't get stunned. Swallow you whole deals double damage when they're below 25% health. Okay, for this guy, definitely set up Curse of Doom, because he's a pain in the ass. And spam Swallow You Whole until I die, because I'm going to die, this guy. It's too annoying for me not to die. Yep, damn, killed me in two hits. How unfortunate. Oh, lucky for me, my carry pet is... Okay, what I'm going to do is wind up, and then supercharge, and then wind up again. Because he has these shields, which makes Toxic Smoke useless. Okay, supercharge. Ooh, as long as I don't die, I should be fine. Curse of Doom should be going off right now. Didn't really do that much damage. And then unleash my wind up. This should be enough to... Ugh, I'm so glad I'm fucking mechanical. Okay, oh damn, that hit hard. Yep, so that guy was still difficult. Whew. If this dude wasn't a mechanical pet, I probably would have died. Which happens a lot with this guy. He's still the toughest. Okay, looks like I'm gonna take a little side mission right here and get rid of this guy. I have that quest for some reason. I think I did the quest, but it like bugged out on me. And I know how to take out these guys really fast. Ooh, I got the fire one. That's cool. I already have them. I think I actually bought them. Can't do that while I'm mounted. Eh, whatever. Let's just heal them up. Let's go to team 11. Actually, you know, I'm gonna go to team 12 right here. Because the team for this guy is right here. Explode. Yeah, my explosion team. Explosion team's pretty nice. Basically, I use my two pets with the highest health that have an explode ability, because it does damage based on your health, and then I use my sunflower to activate sunlight and increase everyone's max health by 50%. Which is what Explode goes off. And Explode ignores damage reducers and damage modifiers and just does pure damage based on 40% of your health. But if you increase your health, that's the only way to actually increase its damage. So it's a real nice way of just killing these legendary pets real fast. So, Sunlight first. Yep, Spike Shield ain't gonna do shit. Two of these guys should be fine. Explosion number one. did 900 something damage, and explosion number 2 actually does more damage because he's an HH type with explosion. As long as I don't die before I can use my one attack, I'm fine. Alright, and my double explosion was enough to kill him. And if the two explosions aren't enough to kill him, which happens sometimes, it's very rarely, like if one of your explosions miss, or they manage to kill your pet before you can actually use them, then the sunflower can just finish him off with his solar beam, since it does double damage. Well, it does extra damage under sunlight. That's why I use the sunflower over anything else with like one of those kinds of abilities. Okay, got that out of the way. Heal. I don't need to heal up my pets. Going to team 11. And I forgot to move my starlet. Okay, here's the starlet. Right here. I move him in flip-flop frog's place. I could probably set up toxic smoke, right? Yeah. Okay, the last tamer, the water guy. He's kind of tough too, actually. The last two guys on the list are no pushovers. And with these ones, I just use... Yeah, I go into the owl, because he takes less damage from them and does flying type abilities. Plus, you really need the liftoff in order to avoid some of the attacks, because they have multi-turn moves, like setups, where they can kill other bird-type pets that don't have a way to avoid it. And the Jade Owl is the only magical-type pet that has flying type abilities, which is great for countering aquatics. Hello there. Look at those water graphics on low. After the patch, I had to lower my graphics even more. Really need to buy a new computer. I have plans on it, but it's probably not going to be a reality for a couple more months. He sets up Whirlpool. And time to switch into my owl. I need to lift off on this turn. If I was faster than my opponent, that would be cool, but that's not happening. I actually don't need to be faster than this guy. Slicing winds doesn't really matter what your speed is. Oh shit, one shot. That was a nice crit. Good job right there. Okay, I'm just gonna slicing winds this guy until I'm dead. Usually, the first guy takes a little bit longer than that. The slicing wind spam until this guy's dead. There's no reason to get faster than this guy either. Even though slicing winds is terrible, and I wish he had a different move for his number one slot. Whatever. Slicing winds has a one. It has a chance to hit 3 times, or 2 times, or once. But there's no way to increase the chance to hit an additional time. It's always just a random 1, 2, or 3 times, which is bad considering the other ones that are multi-turn moves. Usually you can like hit an extra time if you're faster than your opponent, but not for this guy. I really should be on that dude already. Oh, what's his name? That guy. The Dragonbone Hatchling. I should be on him already, but it's like Jade Owl and Dude Work. I should be able to avoid both of those with a liftoff on this turn. Because he likes to time them up nicely. That's what makes the Water Spirit, the pet that you can actually use, really good. Because you can time these up to go off at the same time. Which means you can put up a debuff on your opponent to take double damage while both of those go off and kill people. That's another team I use to take out the legendaries. Wow, the Owl is going to take out his entire team. Damn, good job, Owl. You've been getting lucky with those slicing winds. Usually I get really unlucky, I only get like one hit all the time. Because you need 2 of these hits to go off in order for it to do as much damage as a basic attack. A third hit means you do extra damage. One hit means you did half damage. And it looks like I got really lucky with those slicing winds, and the Owl was able to take out his entire team. Damn. That does not happen often. I got really lucky right there. That one liftoff crit. Okay, that's all of them. That's all the pet tamers. And I even took out one of the legendary guys. And I got doing this without a pet biscuit. It's really bad. I only got to level up one pet, and another one I only got almost level 25. If I had a pet biscuit that increases my experience by like an extra 25 or 50%, I would have been able to level up at least one or two other pets.